Hi, this is my second screencast for Tomcat Clusterite. Check my the first part of the Tomcat Clustering. Here I discuss how to set up the simple load balancer using the Tomcat and the Apache HTTP web server. This is a simple load balancer overall diagrams. Here I put in the one load balancer, it's Apache HTTP web server, and three Tomcat instances. You can run the dedicated server or you can use three instances of the Tomcat. Then we already discussed how it's the load balancer distribute your request using the round robin methods and everything. This is a simply work fine for the static web pages or the if your web application if not using the sessions. But what happen if you use our web application using the sessions, then how this load balancer is actually failed, and we'll find out how to resolve that problem to overcome it's working fine in the normal load balancer. Before going to detail about the what's the problem in sessions in the load balancer, we'll just discuss about the briefly about the session management in the servlet. Usually client is requesting one page like a shopping cart page, so they send the request to the server. Server then create the sessions for that particular user, then respond with the cookie. The cookie actually contain the key value pair. The key usually the J session ID, value is some random number. This random value then futurely Tomcat can identify the particular user. So this random value is also stored in the sessions also. So it's like a hash map kind of algorithms. Key is a session ID and value is the actual session object is stored in server side. So in all future request from the client, they send this cookie to the server. Server then using this session ID, they search from the hash maps of sessions, then they picked up proper sessions. So client perspective, you can purchase a shopping cart, 6-7 items, they all everything stored in the your session objects. Let's see the simple demo. Okay, I'm going to take the single instances to put that one web application with that application using the sessions. It's like a shopping cart kind of one sample applications. Before we see the demo, every Tomcat is shipped with manager web application. This manager web application can be used for deploying the applications as well as see the active sessions and the much more. So by default, the manager web application is disabled. So we need to enable. So go to the any one of the Tomcat instances and go to the config and open the Tomcat users.xml. Here the role name, everything is actually commented, so just remove the comments. After removing the comments, add one user. Username, you can add any username and any password. And roles, this is very important. You can use any username, any password, doesn't matter, but role should be manager-gviewer. If you use any other roles, then you can't use the manager web apps. So give the roles is manager-gui. Okay, then save it. Now run the Tomcat. Okay, my Tomcat is running. Then access the manager web apps. /manager. Use a username what we provided in Tomcat icon users.xml file. So I'm clicking. Here is we can see the list of application is deployed, and here we are interested in this column sessions. How many sessions actually created for that particular web apps? Now I am putting my sample code in the root place. So this is a root. So here we can see how many sessions are created. Now actually zero session, because I'm not accessing anything. Now I'm accessing the website. This is my website. So first time I called, one session ID is created and we send new sessions and it's a session creation time and access time. But when you go manage your apps, when you refresh it, you can see that so one session is created. When you click here, you can see the session ID. This is session ID. You can see the session ID and now compare our page session ID. Both are same. End with 5B and start with A0. Here A0 end with 5B. So same session is created. Suppose I try to access the same website from the different system. Let's consider this one. This is IP of that particular system where I'm running. So when I enter, now there is another session is created, B8 and end with 63. Now go to the manager apps and now see two sessions are created. When you click, you can see that two sessions, one with B8 with 63. Here it's just you can see everything. Now I'm going to add some of the books like in Java, C. This is the shopping carts. I added one by one. You can see here there's a two sessions are created and you can access this is my session. This is my session with 5B, end with 5B. So when you go this session in Tomcat, you can see what actually stored in the session. Java C CPP is stored. Now suppose I'm adding .NET. Just refresh the, you can see now .NET is added. So from the manager web apps, we can see what inside the sessions are actually stored in everything. And this is a thing, what is session name, and this is a, just mentioned this is an old session or new session, when actually session is created, and when last we access that particular session. Now this app is exactly works fine, and I am accessing directly to the Tomcat. I'm not accessing through the load balancer, so it's working fine. What happened when I access through the load balancer? What happened? Let me check. Now, what happened when you use a session with a load balancer? What's the problem actually is we are going to face? Now, take the same scenario. Now, user sending the request, load balancer. Load balancer actually redistribute the request to the round robin method. So, this request first distribute to Tomcat 1. So Tomcat 1, what happened to, they create the sessions and is written with the response. This is normal to the user. It's okay. But the further subsequent request, when the client do again shopping cart add see Java books like this, that time client make the request with the session ID. That's okay. But this time load balancer distribute to another Tomcat. Instead of the first Tomcat, is distribute to another Tomcat. This Tomcat doesn't have the sessions. So what happened, this Tomcat is, this session ID is, it's meaningless. So what happened, they omit the session ID and create a completely new session in the Tomcat 2 and now return the new session ID to the client. Now client is updated the session ID with new ID and next time again same thing happen. So next time user again try to access a page, it's going to the Tomcat. So third Tomcat again create the new sessions, then return the new ID. It's back to the new ID. ID is actually changed. Now fourth time again the request. This time request go to the first Tomcat. But what happened? This ID is, it's not matched with this session ID, because when first time Tomcat session is created, that ID is generated is different than what client now submitted. So Tomcat 1 is again confused, again create the new sessions instead of the continue with old sessions. Let's see the demo. Okay, hi, we're going to start the Tomcat. Before start the Tomcat, I'll show you in root what my application actually have the code. This is my code. This is nothing. It's just one simple JSP like a form and use the sessions. I have the request.get session, get ID, and check the creation time and the last access time. And I have list of books. So in the form I have submitted the books. That books is stored in one list. The list again I stored in the session using the set attribute. So that's a point. So I'm going to take this code and declare it uniformly in all the object instances. So I take this code, go to the second instances, web apps, in root I'm going to deploy this one. And after deployment I in page up statement here I mentioned that the value instance 1 or instance 2 to know about which instance actually the responses respond to client. So we change to instance 2. Like that we need to do same thing in instance 3. So delete and replace the old code and here change to instance 3. Then we can find out actually where exactly the responses comes from. So instance 3. So once saved and I enabled all Tomcat instances, the manager web application for enabling the Tomcat users.xml file. So you need to do everything. The second thing, clear the work folder. Anything inside the work folder, clear it. But actually when you shut down the Tomcats, the sessions also saved in the worker folder only. So for further confusion, you just clear the all the worker folder in all Tomcat instances. Then start Tomcat. First Tomcat is started. Second Tomcat is started. Third Tomcat is started. And I started Apache also. Apache HTTP server. Now I access the manager web apps of each individual Tomcat. Save. This is the first Tomcat, localhost 8081. Now this is, I'm going to access the second Tomcat, 8282 manager. So third Tomcat, localhost 8383. We're going to clearly see what actually going on. So three Tomcat is started. See all Tomcat root active sessions are zero. So that means no sessions are there. So this is the first Tomcat, second Tomcat, third Tomcat. Now I'm going to access the website. So localhost. Here I'm not going to access an individual Tomcat. I'm accessing the load balancer. So localhost. It's a 80. It's Apache server running. So when I access it, okay, this time suddenly this from instance 2 my first request is coming. Actually Apache using the load balancer request is distributed across using the round robin method. So first time I'm getting the instance 2. So go to the second, this is the second instance, just refresh it. See the one active session is created. When you see the any other instances, when you refresh, zero, there's no sessions. But here first session is created in the second instances. When you see the session ID, this is my session ID. So you just verify that one, go inside, same sessions, it's ended with 9c, it's ended with 9c. The same session ID is created, it's a completely new session. Now when I entered something Java and add to cart, now actually problem is starting. Before it's, when I showed in the single Tomcat, it's showing add cart is working fine. But here what happened when you click, now it's added, of course it's good, but new session is created instead of following old one. See DE, new session is created in instance 1. You want to verify, go and just refresh the first instance. Instance is created. When you go deep, you can see the DE. You go on deep further, you can see Java is created. So come to that. Now what happened? Now I am suppose adding C, C language. Okay, when you click, it's instead of add the cart, it's just showing the only last entries. This time in instance 3 and 48, the new session ID is created. You can imagine pre-verify this one, same thing. Now, next time I'm adding something. For example, I add .NET and add to cart. This time instance 2. First time my entry go to the instance 1, instance 2 only. This time also after the full circle, I'm again come to the instance 2. But my entire list is empty. Why? This time another session is created. Now when you go to the second Tomcat, you go to the main page and refresh it. See, two sessions are created. Even though I'm using single client, like only single tab I'm using, single Chrome, but still two sessions are created. Why this happen actually happening? You can see in through the developer tools. Go to the network. Now add any one of the new books, anything you added. Response comes. Now clearly see everything, we can understand. Go to the headers. This is a request page. Now request is what happened? They send one old cookie, which is already stored in the client. They send the old cookie to the, this time instance 3. But instance 3, this ending with the 240 is not available. Go and check it. This is instance 3. Ending with 240 is not available. But when you come back, when you see the 240 in, actually ending with 240 is available in the second target, not in the third target. So in client is just send the session ID to the this value to the third target. But third target they don't have the new the session ID. So what happened? When you see new session is actually created. DB ended with a D6. When you see here, the D6 new session ID is created and sent to client. So what happened? This is an issue. Every time we enter the some value, it's going to the different Tomcat instance. So each time the new session is created unnecessary. When I enter something, every time when you see here new session is created, it's a this is a boolean variable to show that this is a new session or old session. So every session, new session is created. As a result, you can't use the your session based web application in the this load balancer. See now that first Tomcat 9 active sessions are created, and when you see the here 10 sessions are created, here another 10 sessions. So but I am using single web page, it should be creating single session, but here unnecessary lots of sessions are created. My entire web application is working abnormally. So this is a problem we'll find out. So how we make this web, our web application working fine in the load balancer? So there is one concept called session affinity or sticky sessions. What this sticky session mention? So this concept is simple. First, we are making one request to the server. Which Tomcat actually process the first request of that particular client? All further subsequent requests should be processed by the same Tomcat instance only. Here every time client make the request, it first go to the first Tomcat, then go to the first second Tomcat, then goes to third Tomcat. Instead of that, what session affinity is mentioned? What session affinity is mentioned? If first request it's going to anyone, either Tomcat 1, 2, 3. Suppose we consider the Tomcat is going Tomcat 3. Then from this Tom user perspective, this from this user, all further subsequent requests should go through Tomcat 3 only, not any one of Tomcat. This is method is called session affinity. Suppose here I am sending one request. The request first suppose goes to the Tomcat 1. So the Tomcat 1 created sessions. Then all further subsequent sessions goes to the Tomcat 1 only. So Tomcat 1 already have the sessions. So our site is our web application working normally as we set up the session affinity. this is a main point. Now in load balancer perspective, any request comes, load balancer doesn't know about this previous request is which Tomcat is actually processed. So how we know? Based on session ID only. But session ID actually is a random number, it's generated by each individual Tomcat. So load balancer is, they can't know based on the session ID which Tomcat actually is generated. The session usually contains a random number, which is a peak random numbers. So apart from the random number, we need to append the worker name of the this Tomcat. Suppose the random number is 42 bits length, then add the worker name. Suppose this worker name is Tomcat 1, so add the Tomcat 1 append to the session ID. So next time client send the request, we just load balancer check the session ID ending with which worker name. So based on that worker name, all the further subsequent request is forward to that particular Tomcat only. Let's see how to make it to generate the session ID like that. So there's one property called JVM root. We need to add it into the server.xml file in engine tag. It's like this. Now engine is Catalina. This is Ashley driver. Here we need to add JVM root equal to Tomcat 1. This is a worker.properties file. What is the worker name you given? You can give any worker name. The same name should be mentioned in the JVM root. Now, when you once you mention JVM root, now this is a session ID. This session ID is just a random number and is a big value. Random number with alphabetic, like a hexadecimal value. Now what happened when you add the JVM root? Here it's appended the worker name like this. It's like this. We added the Tomcat 1 is added here. And this is in mod JK, we already know this is a worker name. So based on the worker name, we need to add the file. Let's see the demo. So what we need to first shut down all the Tomcat instances. Once shut down, go to the work cleanup. This is cleanup is not necessary, but in manager, if you not clean up, the manager still showing the last active sessions also. So just clean it. Clean the all the workers. Okay, once clean it, go to the config and take the server.xml file. You can add the JVM root. JVM root equal to worker class name. This is a third instance. So worker class is Tomcat 3, what I provided in workers.properties file. So just copy this one. Now append to Tomcat 2 instance. File. We just add it. Its name is Tomcat 2. Then go to the instance 1. Configuration file and they open the server.xml file. Here make it Tomcat 1. And everything's ready. Now start the all the instances. Okay, 3 Tomcat instances started. Now close it. Just refresh one by one. See, so active sessions are gone 0. Okay, now everything is ready. Now I'm running the again like this. I'm accessing the local host. This time Tomcat instances actually made it the process my request. See the session. This is the main difference between that one. Now session ID is not only the something random number, now append with dot Tomcat 3. This is the JVM root what we mentioned. So the append with the session ID. So the whole, this is called a session ID. This is stored in the cookie in the client side. Okay, Now this is a new session is created. So go and check. Of course, new session is created. See that one, new session, Tomcat tree. Now what happened? Second time I make the request, like I make it Java. When I had got 2, see this time still Tom insert 3 only, and this is not a new session. That means old session is continued. Meaning is like this. So when add C added CPP added .NET add. So now what happened? Only one session is actually created. No other further sessions are created. You go and check the manager apps of each Tomcat. There is no session is created. Only one session is created in that Tomcat tree only, and all further subsequent requests is processed in Tomcat tree only. This is a session affinity when you implemented our own session based applications working. Okay, before that, you can check through the course. So developer course, you just add anything you can check. Now cookie is like this only. So they send the cookie 8080 and Tomcat tree. It's available in the Tomcat tree. 88 Tomcat tree is available. So Tomcat tree is still processing and give the perfect output. That's the point here. Now what happened? One of the things, this is providing good load balancer. So when you not created sessions, it's distributed to among all the Tomcat instances. Your Tomcat is not created any sessions, then it distribute to all Tomcat instance as it's a old method. This is session affinity. So suppose my system, I have the session in some other workflow only. So all other places I'm not created any session, then your request is processed to all Tomcat instances. But after sometimes I created a session, then after sometimes I created my session is created only by Tomcat 3, then my further all the requests go into Tomcat 3 only. So this is a sessions affinity. Or what happened, one of the Tomcat instances actually failed. So what happened? Suppose I'll show you the demo. Okay, this is the instance 3 actually process these websites. So I'm going to create another one. Okay, this time I'm using the another browser. Actually I'm using Windows. I'm accessing this website load balancer. This time instance 2 is created. See the session ID with instance 2, Tomcat 2 is coming. Now I'm creating Java or something. Okay, now it's created. Now what happened? Suppose one of the Tomcat, actually here I'm using Tomcat 2 and Tomcat 3 only. That's mean my system's using, actually this is a one of the browser I'm using. Its processes comes from the instance 3. And one of the browser I'm using, the process, all process comes to instance 2. Suppose instance 3 is failed, what happened? Let's see that one. So I'm going to shut down the instance 3. So shut down instance 3. Okay, instance 3 is shut down. Now what happened the outside? Which one is comes from instance 2, Tomcat? So I'm add another one, like C. See, it will not affect it. So in our instance, Tomcat 3 is down, but which one you are using Tomcat instance 2 still continue as it is. So now we see another one. Which browser you are using instance 3, you try to add, what will happen? See, this is another thing. So what happened, one instance is failed. It's like this, one instance is failed. All user who's associated with that particular Tomcat instance or all sessions are lost. This is one of the drawback in this model, because our sessions are not replicated. So what happened here, you provide high availability. High availability in not fully, partially can provide high availability. That means your services still can accessible by all other users, But what are the user? They already used the one particular instance, that instance which going to the failed. So that user actually lost the sessions, but they still can access a web page, but their shopping cart information are all lost. This is a drawback of this method. We'll see the next one, how to replicate the sessions to across a Tomcat. So even though one Tomcat is going failed, all other users, even that user who used the particular Tomcat, they still can access their sessions. We'll see in the next video. If you have any suggestion or any improvements, please let me know. Thank you.